So this is for the 5 year second year students as well as 3rd year mechanical engineering students. So under an university syllabus, we have 5 units for this subject, principles of management. In this, we have the first unit, introduction to management and organization. In introduction to management, we will be seeing various management theories under the topic evolution of management, the various management theories like Henry Fayol theory, Taylor theory, etc. And that will be, we will be also talking about types of business organization. Unit 2, we will be talking about planning. So, this subject, before we see what are the units we are going to take, let us see the subject which we are going to deal about. What it deals about? This subject deals about the how to run a company. You are going to complete BE for 4 years. Suppose you are going to own an organization. You are going to run your own business. How to build a company from scratch? What are the things you have to do before starting up your own organization? You are going to become an entrepreneur. What are you going to do? That is the important subject. So whenever you are going to start a company, you are going to plan. What this company is going to do. So, for planning, you have to set up objective. What is my company about? It is about manufacturing of, say, two-wheelers, or manufacturing of cement, or it is construction company, it's a real estate company. What it is going to deal about? So, I have to plan my objectives. Then, I will do how to go about it. So, the units are planned in such a way that whatever we are going to do in a company, how we are going to manage a company, the units are structured in that. First, we plan what we set up the objective. So, we will be studying management by objectives, and we will be studying about the management process and decision making process in Unit 2. Unit 3, so we have planned what we are going to do. I have planned what my company is going to do. I want people to execute my plan. So, I have to recruit people. So, in various levels. So, that can be done to use organization structure and departmentation, and also we will be learning about line and staff control in Unit 3. So, this will be the total how I am going to manage my people. So I have recruited people. Now I have to extract work from them. I have to manage them and I have to make the people achieve my objectives. So for that I have to motivate them. I need good leaders. So I will have two things under Unit 4. That will be theories of motivation, theories of leadership under Unit 4. Unit 5, so up to this, I have done something to manage my company. In Unit 2, as you might remember, we have set up some objectives. So, whether this objective which I have planned in planning stage of Unit 2, whether I have achieved it, I have to check it. According to my objective, whether I have achieved. So, whether I have achieved my objectives, for that I do something called controlling. With controlling, I can achieve the objective. Now we will see one by one the various units. Various parts of my video lecture series which is coming up will deal with various units. In this video, we will see about Unit 1, the theories of management. So, in Unit 1, there is management theories. So, one of the very important RP questions for our university exam is the Henry Fayol 14 principles. So, this 14 principles I have listed out here, very important for exam purposes. So, kindly pay attention to this. The first principle, Henry Fayol 14 principles of management, first principle is division of work. So, when I manage a company, I have to divide work among various groups. I have to set up various teams and queue work. he will be able to work, perform the work better. So that is division of work. The second one is authority and responsibility. Authority and responsibility. So what is authority? I have the authority to do certain things as a manager. As a deputy manager, I have some authority to do. Authority to execute a work. So what is authority? Authority is nothing but the power which a employee has in that organization. That is authority. Responsibility. Responsibility is what are the duties I have to execute, what are things I have to do for achieving the objectives set up during the administration. That is responsibility. So what is my responsibility? What is my authority? Authority is by which I extract work. Responsibility is by which I do my own work. That is responsibility. So discipline. So if employees have to achieve something in the organization, they have to come on time. They have to do certain things in a certain way. So that is discipline. They have to do things in order. So that is, they have to behave in a particular way as the company rules. That is discipline. Unity of command. So this is another point under the 14 principles, another principle. So unity of command is, so unity of command when a person, when when a person in an organization structure directs a person below him, he gives work to him, he commands him. So an employee receives the orders from one person. In many cases, he may receive from 2-3 persons, which creates confusion. So that should not happen. Unity of command is the work which should be done by an employee should come from only one person. That means I should have only one boss. I cannot have 2-3 bosses. So that is unity of command. Unity of action. A team in the project should work towards common goal. It should have only one goal. That is unity of direction. You go in one direction. Subordination of individual interest to general interest. What we want as an activity and perform as a part of company, I should place the company interest before my interest. I should not think about my interest in whatever happens in the company, whatever responsibility I do, whatever actions I carry out for them. So that should be in the interest of the company, not in my own individual interest. That is subordination of individual interest. So second point. So remuneration of personnel. Remuneration should be fast. The salary remuneration means the income which we give to employee. That should be fair. It should be the according to the wage equivalent to the market. So that should be the remuneration of personnel. A centralization. So normally what happens? The decision is taken by certain people in the top level of management. Certain decisions are given to the authorities down the line. So a company performs well when the decisions are decentralized. When the thing which has to be decided is decentralized, the freedom of doing the work is more. So decentralization is always good for the company. So that has to be taken care of. This 8.8 is to centralize. Right? What? Scalar change. Scalar change is nothing but similar to unity of direction. Top to bottom. In an organization structure, a CEO should instruct the general manager. General manager should instruct the project manager. Like that, the order should follow in a from top to bottom. That is scalar chain. Scalar chain is nothing but top to bottom approach. So next we will deal about 10th principle is order. So order, we have material order, social order. Material order is things in the right place. Be the worker who is working for the company, manager, especially in the manufacturing process, he has to place things in order. Everything has to be in its own place. That is order. Equity. So I told you. That is one point that I gave. Or equal to middle order or social order. So things in proper place is middle order. Social order is person in correct place. That is social order. 11th, equity. So for the management, all the persons should be treated equal. There should not be any prejudice among the employees. So that is equity. Stability of tenure of personnel. The concept that is bothering the managers around the world who are in corporate is the employees turnover. The employees leave the company frequently. So the chain of work is negligent in that. So what happens? The personnel should continue in the same company for a considerable amount of time, for a long period of time, so that he is familiar with the work and he is familiar with the company and the work proceeds in a smooth manner. So third one is initiative. The person working for the company should have their own drive to do the work. Everything cannot be set for all the tasks. So he should have his own personal drive, interest to do the work. That is initiative. The last point is split into options. So these are the 14 principles. So the other, this is the, as I told you, this is a very important question. Another important question is FW Taylor principle that we will see in the next video. Please subscribe, like and share.